So quickly, let me solve one problem. So this is the steps which we have already seen. Yeah, one more thing to be noted here. You will see here, calculate the design load PD. Okay, let me go for the problem and then I will explain what is the design load PD. So these are the formulas which we have already derived. So I will give you the slides later. Okay, so problem one is this one. The pull in the tie rod of an iron group truss is 50 kN. Okay, the load given to us is 50 kN. Design a suitable adjustable screw joint. See here, it is not given turnbuckle, but it is given adjustable screw joint. That means turnbuckle. The permissible stresses are in tensile 75 MPa. That means we are given sigma T, shear 37.5, sigma S, and crushing is sigma C. So now, all of you, should we go for factor of safety here?
No, sir.
No. What's the reason?
Yield stress ne di hai, sir.
Yes. In question, we are not given with yield stress. We are directly given with the permissible stress. So if permissible or allowable or safe stress or workable stress are given, then we don't have to divide by factor of safety. Okay. Now, let us start with the problem. Now, in the question, we are given that load is 50 kN. But in screw joint, turnbuckle, we will not use load only this much, 50 kN. Now, what's the reason behind this? Let us say this is a rod. Or this is a tie rod. On which this load is acting. But along this load, we also are rotating it. देखो बिना रोटेट किए आगे जाएगा क्या?
No, sir.
नहीं होगा. So that means at the same time it is subjected to torque as well as the tensile load. That means there is a combined loading on the rod. So if there is a combined loading, we don't use this P as it is. We find out the design load. That is PD. And PD empirical relation is 1.3 times the actual P. Again, I repeat. We find design load just because there are two different types of load acting at the same time. One is the tensile load and one is the rotation. So it will be 1.3 times 50. So what will be the answer? I think 65. Yes, 13 into 5, 65. So this is the load, PD, which we will take in our further design calculations. Okay, let us start. The first type of failure or first component which we take is the tie rod.
Sir, time ho gaya.
The first part is tie rod, and in tie rod we have found out or we have seen that there will be only tensile failure. And for tensile failure, we have the formula sigma T is equal to P divided by pi by 4 d c square. That is the pore diameter square, because it will break at the minimum cross section area, that is dc. So pi by 4 dc square. Now in this particular equation, I have the value of sigma t with p, that is 75. I have the value of p. Now I will use the design load, not the given load. So it will be 65 into 10 raised to 3 divided by it will be pi by 4 into dc square. Now quickly give me the answer for dc. Solve and give me the answer for dc.
33.21.
okay, 33.21. Now can I approximate it to somewhere around 40? Yes
sir.
Yeah, the answer is no, you cannot, because the core diameter, we are not manufacturing it. We are taking the standard parts. Screw and nuts are the standards. जो हमको चाहिए वो नहीं मिलेगा. Market में जो है वो हमको use करना पड़ेगा. There are some standards of screw threads. So we cannot approximate directly DC as 40 or something what you want. So what you need to do, you need to check it in the available series of threads. So for that, I have the table with me now here. So what you need to do, you need to check 33.21, greater than 33.21 is where in the table? So here you can see in the fifth column. Now we are designing the bolt. So in the fifth column, you have to check where this 33 point, what value we got? 33.21, yes. So if you can see here, there is 4.733, then continued here. So we will see that, yes, 34, yes, this is the value. So the standard value available, just with near to our calculation is 34. So, but we will not select this, we will go some on the higher side. Let us go for this one. So I will finalize that my DC will be 41.795. I cannot approximate to 40 because it is not the standard one. And if DC is this one, come to this line. And in second column, you can see this number 5 is nothing but the pitch. You can see here in this column, pitch, heading. And the third column, is the nominal diameter or D. So I will write here, this is my pitch, this is my D, and this is my DC. So I will write here also DC as, so my final answer is DC is equal to how much? 41.795 mm. And because this is DC, my D will be 48 mm and pitch will be is equal to 5 mm. Okay, so finding out one answer, I have found out three different parameters, that is DC, D and P. Any doubts?
No, sir.
Okay, so we have completed the design of the rod. The second part is what? Second part is the
design of
coupler. Sir, mention nahi karne ka tha.
Coupler nut. And for coupler nut, the first criteria is like it says tensile criteria.
Sir, mention karne ka kahan se liye?
Yes. The page number which you will get is PSG 5.42. Good question. ये जो वैल्यूज है वो हमको मिलती है PSG 5.42 से. PSG 5.42 अगर यहां नहीं मिली सो वी विल गो इन RS Kurbi टेबल नंबर 11.1 विच आई हैव द फोटो विच आई हैव शोन दिस RS Kurbi 11.1. You can also check on PSG 5.42. The same table will be there. Sigma T is equal to P divided by pi by 4 capital D square minus D square. Now in this, what is unknown? Yes, in this what is unknown?
Outer diameter
of the coupler nut. So sigma T was given to us as, I think, 75, correct? P is given to us as 65 kilonewton design load divided by pi by 4 capital D square minus this small d we have just found out as 48. It is 48 square. So on solving this, I will get answer for D as how much?
58.37.
Let us approximate it to 65 mm. Now in the B part, we will consider the crushing failure. And in crushing failure, we know that sigma C is equal to P divided by pi by 4. One ring will be D square minus DC square. This is the area of one ring, and there are n number of such rings which will be pressed. So it will be multiplied by n. So sigma C value is given how much?
90 megapascal.
So it is 90. 65 into 10 raised to 3 divided by pi by 4. D is known to me as 48 square minus DC. DC we found out as how much? 47 point something. What was that value? 41.795. Yes. So 41.795 square. So now multiplied by N. Now in this equation, the only unknown is N, that is number of tons. So please find out N and give me the answer.
1.65. Yes, 1.65.
That means number of tons which are minimum. The minimum number of tons are engaged are 1.65. So let us go for not more than 4 tons. Yeah, 3 bhi aap le sakte ho. It is just an approximation. How much you want to keep? Kam se kam itne tons chahiye, 1.65. So number of tons cannot be in decimals. So let us go for 3, 4, 5, anything what you want. Okay, third part. Third part is the shear. And in shear, we know that sigma S is equal to, again, P divided by, it will be rubbed on pi multiplied by dc. You can also multiply it by pitch, because it will travel that much distance, and there are n number of such threads, so it will be multiplied by n. Now, everything on the right hand side is known to me, so I will just find out what is sigma s induced. So sigma s induced will be 65 into 10 raised to 3 divided by pi multiplied by dc is 41.795. pitch was 5 mm from the table, and n we just now approximated at 4. So what is sigma s induced? Give me the answer. What is sigma s induced?
24.75
Newton per. So what can I write now? I will write sigma s induced is less than sigma s allowable, because it was allowable was given to us as 37.5. And finally, what I can write?
Design is safe.
Finally, I will write design is safe. Okay, and the last part now. The last part is the, what is the last part?
Design of coupler.
Design of a coupler. And for coupler, we know that only tensile force will be acting. So I will write sigma t is equal to p divided by, area will be pi by 4 d2 square. Pi by 4 d2 square minus d1 square. Outer diameter square minus inner diameter square. But from here I can write empirical relation. I will use d1 is equal to, where d1 is equal to d plus 6, assuming 3 mm clearance on each side. And the d was how much? I think 48. So 48 plus 6 will give you 54 mm. So d1 is known to me. So I will now substitute. In place of sigma t, I will write 75 is equal to, p is given to us as how much? Yes, 65 into 10 raised to 3 divided by pi by 4. D2 is unknown, so it will be d2 square minus d1 we just now found out as 54. So 54 square. So the only unknown is, the question is outer diameter of the coupler, which is d2. And give me the answer for this.
63.4.
Okay, that is the minimum. Yeah, okay, no problem. 63.4. So I can approximate two to, let us say, again I repeat, this 63.4 is the minimum diameter. Humko iske upar hi jana hai. So it will be, let us say, d2 is equal to 75 or 70 mm, whatever you feel like you can take. So this completes the entire design procedure for design of turn buckle. Any doubts?
No, sir.
Okay.